dancing free. If you wanna have fun, come along with me. Say, hey, good looking, what you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?
We're gonna start making our tuna mousse. Sounds delicious. Where do you see all the yummy ingredients that we're gonna put in it? All right, so on the stove right now, I have a pot with 1.5 tablespoons of unflavored gelatin. I just get this good old yummy gelatin right here. So it's about 1.5 envelopes of that. And then 1/2 cup of cold water and 1/4 cup of lemon juice, and you just put it on the stove until it's fully dissolved. So I'm gonna go grab that now. Yum, fully dissolved unflavored gelatin with some lemon juice. All right, so we're gonna put that in here. Make sure you get every last drop of that. And the next step calls for, we're gonna add the mayonnaise, which it calls for 1 cup of mayonnaise. Yummy. Sure you get every drop of that too. All right, next up, we are gonna put all the other remaining ingredients in except for the cream. So the next ingredient is going to be 2 cups of tuna. Make sure it's chopped up. Yummy. All right, next it calls for 1/2 cup of cucumbers. My hands are clean. And then we're gonna do 1/2 cup of celery, already chopped up. And then 1/4 cup of green olives, because every recipe has to have green olives and unflavored gelatin. That's a must in retro kitchen recipes. Okay, so then we're going to add 2 teaspoons of onion juice. Never in my life have I had a recipe that called for onion juice. My only option is to do this and try and get some juice in there from the onion. And we're gonna get 2 teaspoons worth. Check out that onion juice. And do one more. All right. That could be 2 teaspoons, could be 4, we don't know. All right, next up is 1.5 teaspoons of horseradish. Yum. One and a half teaspoons of horseradish. Next up, we're gonna do 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Quarter teaspoon salt, 1/4 teaspoon of paprika. All right, so that's all the remaining ingredients minus the cream. It's So we're gonna stir this up. Doesn't that look delicious? So it's gelatin, lemon juice, tuna, green olives, cucumbers, celery, onion juice. I can barely contain myself. I almost just want to eat it now. All right. So after that's mixed well, which to me it looks pretty mixed well, we're going to fold in a cup of whipping cream. Now we're going to pour it into our loaf pan. Make sure that olive's down in there. All right, so now this is going to go into the refrigerator to chill. Welcome back to Retro Kitchen. I got Ian in the kitchen with me today.
Hello.
So today's recipe comes from Better Homes and Gardens, Barbecue and Picnics, the newest in barbecuing. The newest. So this recipe is tuna mousse. Let's check it out.
Alrighty. Cut me up a slice.
Of course, a big ginger would like a slice. Apparently, it smells like dog food. She's been really wanting to try it.
It does look like some kind of like tuna salad, though. Like, honestly, I might like this like a lot. It does look really like chunky chili. Ooh, let's look at this side. I like shit like this. I might actually really like this.
Okay. I'm not that big of a fan of tuna, so.
Ready?
Hang on, I gotta get a slice here.
There you go. That's really good. I like tuna a lot.
I mean, why is it really good?
It's really good. Like, honestly, like, you're right though. Like, this would be really good with, like, some chips or something like that.
Like crackers.
Oh, my God. Yeah, this is, like, awesome.
I don't know. I got to the tuna.
I could clean this plate. This is really good. The parts where it's not the tuna is actually the part that throws me off a little bit. Because it's almost like a jello-y coating around the tuna, and that's the consistency that really bugs me. But other than that,
I could do without the tuna. I could do everything without the tuna.
Oh my God. That's what makes it good for me. You don't like tuna?
It's like fishy.
No, I mean, honestly, this makes me want to put green olives in my tuna, like tuna sandwich.
I don't even think I got a green olive.
We'll try, I mean, I'm sure it's not going to change your opinion at all because you don't like tuna, but I think this is awesome.
The flavor is really good and I liked that when I first bit it, but then I got tuna.
That's awesome. You could even take this up a notch, I bet. Put some buffalo sauce in it, make it like a buffalo.
It has paprika, so you can put some hot sauce in it.
Maybe. Crisp.
I'll try celery. So now you like this one and I don't.
Oh yeah, this is quality.
This is like cat food quality.
Meow.
Though he also eats Vienna sausages, so that kind of gives you his quality of taste buds.
No. You fed them to me when I was a baby, so that's your fault.
Yeah, they were cheap.
That's why I like them so much.
And they were baby Vienna sausages. They weren't like the Vienna sausage. They were like in those little baby jars, little meat sticks.
I eat them for lunch at
my
job.
And they stink just like Vienna sausages. I don't know.
I might eat this one.
So, in case y'all didn't know about this channel, this is just one of the tons of vintage cookbooks I have. So, I will be making all kinds of unique, yummy, maybe, recipes in these cookbooks. So, stay tuned for that. While you clean your plate, you want to sticker for your clean the plate.
I'll lick it.
That is disgusting.
I think it's really good.
I feel like it smells like a fish market.
What do you think, Ginge? She approves.
Yeah, because it smells like dog food, cat food. She's like, why are you guys eating my food? All right, well, on to next time.
Just looking the crap out of it.